Hi guys, so in this video we're going to cover a couple of things. We're going to cover HMOs versus apartments, that's the first thing. And secondly, should you leverage? So let's talk about HMOs versus apartments. Now, we get a lot of inquiries about HMOs, but the reality is, with a number of things that's going on at the moment with things like the energy crisis and legislation regarding HMOs, it's probably not the best investment out there. So let's talk about an HMO. Whereas previously you could do things like a 6-bedroom HMO and comfortably let that out with no regulation at all, the regulation now kicks in at 4-bedroom. So you need fire doors, you need fire extinguishers, you need fire blankets, you need a number of things to license that HMO. And in some cities, you actually need a special HMO license. So the reality is, by the time you've added all these costs up, it's actually better to go for an apartment. Now, the reason why people always thought HMOs were better is because you can get a number of individuals in there that typically pay a premium on the room. But actually, once you take into account the cost of tax, which can actually be far beneficial in an apartment, again, and you average out the profit, the apartments win, hands down. Now, why is that adding to the fact now? Well, because you have a cost of living crisis, people want smaller properties. They want properties which are typically less to heat. So what do you get with an HMO? Well, with an HMO, you may be in a property with 4, 5, 6 other people, and you may be the person that's going to work every day, but you're sharing the bill. So you may be the person going to work, but you've got 3 or 4 people there that are sitting there all day using the heat, using the electric, using the TV, and you're sharing that bill. And that's not what people want now. People don't want to be wasting their money. So they rent an apartment on their own, a smaller apartment, a 1-bed, and what do they get? Well, they use and pay for the electric that's actually used every single month. They pay for the TV license if they want, and they don't have to pay for bills when they're not there. So that's why an apartment is always, in our opinion, and it's proved to be far better than HMO. Importantly as well, HMOs outside of the city, apartments are in the city centre. And we are noticing far more people come back to the city centre to be close to the bars, the restaurants, and everything else that goes with city centre living. And that's where the job market's at as well. So without a shadow of a doubt, apartments are far greater than HMOs. But we also come onto things like leveraging, because when it comes to buying an apartment or buying any property to that, we have a lot of clients who say, I'm gonna try and do it in cash. Well, actually, if you can do it in cash, you could probably get 4 apartments if you leverage. Now, there's 2 things you've got to take when you're leveraging. There's the money that you put down, which is your cash deposit, and there's the money that you borrow, and that's free money. We know you might say it's not free money, but it genuinely is. You cannot get that if you do a stock. You cannot get that if you do other investment vehicles. That's not your money. So if you've got a £200,000 property and you've got £50,000 in that property, well, that other £150,000, it's not yours. So if you're paying 3-4% interest on that money, but you're actually making 5-6%, you are making 2% on that free money. And if you're making 6% on that £50,000, well, that's it, you've got 6% on that £50,000 cash. So think of leveraging as a way to get more bang for your buck. You've got free money here, and as long as the cost or the income that you're getting is higher than the cost of the mortgage, then you're making money on that free money. And don't forget as well, if you've got a £200,000 property and you're making 5-10% growth a year, whatever it may be, the reality is you're making 10% growth on 200,000, not just your 50. So if you've got your 10% growth on 200,000, so £20,000, you've got £20,000 profit. Again, if you only invested £50,000, like you would in a stock, you would only get £5,000 profit. So you're making 4 times as much. Why? It's because you've got this free money from the bank, essentially. So is it worth leveraging? 100%. Well, I hope that helps. Very short video. And if you want anything more and more detail, just get in contact.